Hi, this is Sergey from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we are going to take a look at a newly released knife from CRKT. They just released this knife at the Blade Show of 2017, and this is certainly one of my favorites of the new knives that they released there, and it is the CRKT Prowess. A really cool new design from CRKT and Canonian, so a Canonian design here. Very nice flowing lines, as you can see here. It is also marked on the blade as well. And just an overall nice knife, in my opinion. Just looks really cool. And also now that I had it for a couple of weeks, it really is a nice and well-performing blade here from CRKT. You can see here, it fits my hand really well. And now let's take a look at the specs of this knife. So we have an overall length here on the CRKT Prowess of 7¾ inches or 19.7 centimeters. That gives us a blade length of 3.4 inches or 8.6 centimeters. The steel that they're using here is AUS 8, and we have a blade thickness of 2.75 millimeters, so a little bit thinner than on some other knives that CRKT and some other companies are releasing at the moment. And I actually like that because it gives this knife a very great slicing performance. Then we have a hand length of 4.4 inches or 11.2 centimeters. So a really nice mid-sized blade here, good for EDC, but also can be used in some harder tasks where you really need a nice hand-filling handle that you certainly get here on the Prowess. So very, very cool overall design in a good size. Now let's take a look at the weight of this knife. And it weighs 126 grams or 4.45 ounces. And that is a little bit of a ding on this knife because for its size, that is quite a hefty weight. And of course, one of the reasons why it is that heavy is because they did not skeletonize the liners here on this knife. So that certainly adds a little bit of weight. It's just an overall very sturdy construction, but that certainly shows in the weight there. And I would love to see a lighter weight version of this with drilled out liners. That would certainly be a nice addition if we could get the weight of this knife under 4 ounces. But as it is right now, it's certainly not overbearing, it's not extremely heavy, it's just a little bit heavier than I would like to see on a knife of this overall size. Now let's take a closer look at the 3.4 inch long AUS 8 steel blade of the CRKT Prowess. And you can see here you have a very, very attractive blade shape and also a very, very useful blade shape, as I have experienced through my use and carry. Really, really great blade shape and also nicely executed here by CRKT. You really see the influence of Canonian here in this blade design. A lot of belly, very flowing lines and quite good looking with this light sweatshirt at the top. Also, the finish is done really well. You have a very, very high polish satin finish here. You can see the reflection of my window there. So very, very nicely done here on the finishing of the blade here. And I also think that the blade is the star of the show here on the Prowess. Very, very good looking and very useful blade shape as well. You have a thinner blade stock, as I mentioned before, of 2.75 millimeters. And that combined with a quite high flat grind and a rather broad blade gives this knife a very nice slicing performance. You can also see here how thin it is behind the edge. Really well done. And it also came very, very sharp out of the box. So very well done there, CRKT. Of course, you have the CRKT logo, the new one that they changed a couple of years ago. And then if you flip it around, we can see all the other markings you have here. The marking for the IKBS pivot system that they have here in the pivot that makes this a really nice smooth flipper. Then we have the model name Prowess and the designer Canonian, as well as their model number here, K290KXP. So really well done here on the blade. You also have a generous sharpening notch here where you can easily sharpen the blade all the way to the heel. They had a little bit of a problem there, so it's not perfectly sharpened here in the heel area, but that's not that big of a deal. So overall, I really like the blade shape and design. You also have some useful jimping here on the spine of the blade that really keeps your thumb where it should be. So overall, I really like the blade shape that they have done here. And of course, the steel that they're using here is AUS 8, and the knife is also made in Taiwan and not in China, which is, in my opinion, certainly a little step up in the quality department. And AUS 8 is a well-known, widely used Japanese blade steel that is a really good budget steel, in my opinion. Certainly has outperformed ATR13 MOE and some other botched steel in my experience, and also has a good edge retention, good corrosion resistance, pretty fine grain structure, and a relatively high toughness. And of course, because it's not a super steel, it is also quite easy to resharpen. So for a user blade, certainly a good steel that CRKT has chosen here for their Prowess model. Now let's take a closer look at the handle design and construction. And you can see here right off the bat that you have a polymer or FRN type handle. And I personally don't really like these polymer or plastic type handles, because I think they mostly feel very cheap and just don't give me the haptic feedback that I like to have from a handle. And they are also not the most pretty to look at. And I had a lot of different FRN style handles, like for example here from Spyderco. I think it certainly gives you some traction there, but it just feels a little bit hollow, a little bit cheap. So I'm not a big fan of that kind of polymer handle scale. But I really like how CRKT executed it here on the handle of the Prowess. It's a very nice fine texturing that really gives you a lot of grip here. Feels very nice. And I really feel like this handle is not lacking in comparison to a G10 or something like that. Of course, a micarta handle or something in that realm would look a little bit nicer and also maybe feel a slight bit nicer. But for the price point of this knife and how they executed the FRN handle, I'm actually quite a fan. They did a really, really good job here. It really does not feel cheap in any way. It really feels like a nice and sturdy and grippy handle. So really well done here on the execution of the polymer handle. Here you also have a polymer backspacer with some jimping on there, and also a slot for your lanyard if you like to carry a lanyard on your knife. So you can do that here as well. And the jimps are a little bit sharp when you come at them from the side like this. Not that big of a deal, but I would like to see them a little bit more rounded. Maybe you can see that here, that is just cut off, and there are a little bit of sharp edges here on the side. Other than that, the handle is designed very, very ergonomically from Ken Onion. He just knows how to do that. So it fits your hand really, really well. You have some useful jimping here at the top on the blade as well as on the handle here. It's not very, very aggressive, so they are slightly rounded, but it gives you a nice indexing point for your thumb while not tearing it up. So really well done here on the jimping there. Of course, you have seen it is a backspacer design, so it have a partially flow-through design as well, and unfortunately no skeletonizing on the inside. And the construction is done via a Torx screw, so you have here two small body screws and then your larger pivot Torx screw here, so you can easily adjust and take apart the knife if you had to do so. And I really like the finishing that they have done here on the screw, so it's like a dark stonewash or something like that, really good looking. And you also have a little bit of a decorative pivot design here on the show side with that yin and yang logo, which certainly gives the knife a little bit of character. So really well done there as well. And then we come to the pocket clip. And this is going to be a little bit of a negative point for some people that really need to carry their knife in a right side tip up configuration, because this knife only enables you to carry it tip down in a right side configuration. So for all your lefties and for all the people that like to carry it at tip up only, that is a little bit of a downer. But I'm not too particular about how I carry my knives. I prefer tip up carry, but I'm also fine with a tip down carry for a knife like this. So for me, it's not that big of a deal, but I certainly wanted to mention that. And the clip itself is done really, really well. Very well done here. CRKT is putting out some excellent clips lately on all of their new models. And here you can see you have a very, very deep carry clip, and they nicely recessed the clip into the polymer handle so that the screw heads are out of the way. So it's very easy to put in your pants here, and they're not going to hang up on the screw heads that hold the clip in place. So very well done. Also, not too large of a clip, really well done. Nice springiness to it. And the polymer handle is not that abrasive that it is going to tear up your pockets there. It really works very well. You also have enough of a lip for some thicker pants. So really well executed on the pocket clip. For a lot of people, it would be nice if they at least could switch it to a tip up carry. One other thing that I noticed is that in most pictures that I saw of the Prowess, the clip is actually a silver color, but on mine here it is black, so I don't know if they changed that in the last minute, but I really like here the black clip, very understated. And if you have a Prowess, let me know if your clip is also black or if it is silver. Other than that, of course, you have a liner lock design with some jimping here, so it's easier to disengage the lock bar. You can also see the lock up here, nice and solid. And a neat thing that I did here is that they actually cut away enough from the scale on this side, so it's very easy to disengage that lock bar and to get to it. So very nicely done, absolutely no problem to get to that lock bar and disengage it. So really cool overall design, nice and ergonomic, very well executed polymer handle scales here that feel really nice and gives you enough traction, so you really feel like you have a lot of control over this Prowess by CRKT. Now let's take a closer look at the centering, lockup and action of the knife. And first off, we have here the centering, and you can see here it is nearly perfect, maybe a tiny bit to the left here, but very well executed, and it hasn't moved since I had it now for a couple of weeks in EDC use. So very well done on centering there. The lockup is absolutely solid, no side to side, no up and down play, rock solid. So, and the pivot point actually features the IKBS ball bearing system, as you can see here by the logo that they put on the blade right there, which is their ball bearing system that they use in a lot of their offerings, like the Ripple, the Crossbones, and some other knives like the Fossil. There are quite a few different knives that feature their IKBS technology, a bearing system, and that they really like to put them in their knives, and I know why. It really gives the knife a very nice smooth action, and that just enhances the overall feel of the knife quite a bit. So here, if you disengage your liner lock, the blade comes falling down nice and smooth. The detent is dialed in very nicely here. It's not a total free faller because you have a lighter weight, thinner blade here, but it certainly feels very, very smooth in hand. And you can see here the flipper tab design is also done really nicely. You have a little bit of a broader flipper tab, so you have a nice place to place your finger right here, and you have some jimping, and it works equally as well in a light switch method like this, or in a push button. So each way you like to deploy it, it works really well, and the detent is just really nicely dialed in. Maybe I can show you that here. Very nicely done. A nice strong detent, so for all of you people that like a very strong detent but don't want to spend a ton of money to get into a nice flipper, I think the Prowess here really fits the bill. Nice action, great lockup here. You can see the lockup on the liner lock, absolutely no play, really well executed here. Just a nice worker EDC in my opinion. Great action, awesome lockup, and just a great overall design by Ken Onion. Now let's take a look at the sharpness of this knife. So I now had it for about 2.5 weeks in my EDC rotation, and I really liked carrying it because of the very, very ergonomic feel in hand, as well as the really, really useful blade shape that we have here with the thinner blade stock there. And now let's take a look how well the edge held up. It came very, very sharp out of the box from CRKT, and you can see here it still is very, very sharp, and I actually really love the blade shape here with that nice gradual belly, and you still have a very pronounced tip. Here you can see the tip strength is not too thick, so you can actually not do some detailed work, but it also is not as strong. So of course, a lot of prying, I wouldn't do that with this knife because the tip here is a little bit thinner, of course, because you start out with a thinner blade stock. But for cutting tasks, this thing just dominates it. Very, very nicely done. Nice and sharp, and it just flies through anything you want to cut, like cardboard, food, paper, anything like that. It works flawlessly. It also has cut some harder things, like some plastic straps and things like that, and it held up great. So overall, a really nice blade here. Now let's take a look at some size comparisons. And first off, let's come to my absolute favorite CRKT knife so far, and it is an older one. It is actually the CRKT Ripple, also a Canonian collaboration. You can see here the older CRKT logo on the blade, and I'm very happy that I could score one of those in this bronze color, really, really good looking. And you can see size-wise, those two knives are very, very similar, but the Ripple here is a lot more slender and just more of a gentleman's style knife in comparison to the Prowess right here, which is more of a no-nonsense user EDC. You can also see that the Ripple is a lot thinner and less hand-filling than the Prowess. And for the clip, I certainly would prefer the one on the Prowess, because this one is a little bit high carry and a little bit too stiff. Then the next comparison I have for you is going to be a knife from Real Steel. Also a knife that I have reviewed previously, and that is the Real Steel H5 Gare Falcon. Also a flipper. This one is actually a frame lock, also has a bearing system inside. And size-wise, those two are also quite similar. You can see here. But I think the CRKT is quite a bit more ergonomic and more hand-filling. If you can take a look at it here, you can see that the Prowess is a little bit thicker in the hand, and it is a dedicated flipper in comparison to the H5 here. But on the H5, you probably are getting a slightly better steel with the 14C28N. This is an older version with the clip that I don't really like, but I think the newer ones have an upgraded clip. But certainly also a nice budget option here, the H5 Gare Falcon from Real Steel. And the last comparison I have for you is going to be one from Boker Plus, and it is the Boris Manasherov designed Caracal. Also a nice heavy-duty user knife with some G10 handles, D2 steel bearing system inside, a dedicated flipper with an opening hole. And this one is going to be quite a bit larger, so you can probably get a good feel of the size of the Prowess when I put those two together. So it's not a very large knife, it's a nice medium-sized EDC blade. And here you have a larger, even more tactical blade here from Boker Plus and Boris Manasherov. And the thickness wise, I think the Caracal is a little bit thicker as well. So I hope you get a good feel for the size of the Prowess. And if you're interested in any of these other knives that I showed you, please check out my review that I did on all of those. Now let's take a look at value and price and come to a final conclusion about this knife. So if you want to get yourself your own CRKT Prowess, you're going to pay just under $50 depending on where you get it. The prices vary a little bit. And I would certainly recommend to check out White Mountain Knives, a really great eBay seller that has some great prices, great international shipping, which is certainly important for me, and is just a good guy to deal with. So I will put the link to his store in the description below. But now let's talk about the knife. So for that price, I think CRKT has put out another really, really viable option when you're searching for a nice, toughly built EDC blade that you can really put through its paces, but you still want a nice blade that can actually cut some things, because it is not totally overbuilt to the place where it has a really thick blade and a very, very thick cutting edge here. So really nicely done with the thinner blade stock, the nice high flat grind, to get a tough blade but still a nice slicing performance as well. So I think with that, they really put a great blade here on this knife. And also the execution of the polymer handles here really surprised me. I thought I wasn't going to like it that much, but it really won me over here with this nice texturing. Of course, you will find a little bit of gunk stuck in there when you're carrying it around, but it's easy to clean. So overall, a nice and grippy handle. Great overall design by Canonian. So overall, I think you get quite a bit of value here from CRKT, also with the AUS8 steel, which is a really good budget steel here that certainly is going to serve you well, and it's also easy to resharpen. So overall, I think CRKT has an awesome year in 2017. You can see some other knives that I have from them, some are from this year and some are older ones. Here we have another Canonian design, one of my absolute favorite CRKT blades, the Ripple. And here are two of the new releases that just really, really impressed me. This is probably the best knife that you can get for the money in the price range of the Pilar. Just an awesome, awesome EDC blade. I would love to see a micarta handled or G10 handled version of this one to put the weight a little bit down. But other than that, an amazing, amazing Jesper Voxnes design, and certainly highly recommended from me if you're searching for a smaller EDC blade. And then here, one of the overall favorite blades of mine from this year, which is the CRKT Crossbones, a Jeff Park design that they just executed absolutely astonishingly well. Gorgeous aluminum handles, great, great clip, IKBS bearing system, very, very lightweight, just a great gentleman's folder here, the Crossbones. And I think they continue that great strive that they had here this year with the Prowess. So this was my review of the CRKT Prowess. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments down below. I will try to answer you there as soon as possible. And if you want to see more of these knife, gun and gear reviews, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.